Morning, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for standing by for So-Young's second quarter 2021 earnings conference call. At this time, all participants are in a listen-only mode. After the management's prepared remarks, there will be a question and answer session. As a reminder, today's conference call is being recorded. I will now like to turn the meeting over to your host for today's call, Ms. Vivian Xu. Please proceed.
Thank you, operator, and thank you for joining So-Young's second quarter 2021 earnings conference call. Please note that the discussion today will contain forward-looking statements made on safe harbor of provisions of the U.S. Private Securities and the Litigation Reform Act of 1995. Forward-looking statements are subject to risks and uncertainties that may cause actual results to differ materially from our current expectations. Potential risks and uncertainties include, but are not limited to, those outlined in our public filings with the SEC, including our annual report on Form 20-F. So-Young does not undertake any obligation to update any forward-looking statement, except as required under applicable law. Join us today on call Mr. Xin Jin, our co-founder, chairman, and CEO, and Mr. Ming Yu, our CFO. At this time, I would like to turn the call over to Mr. Xin Jin. Cass, please.
感谢大家参加新阳2021年第二季度财报电话会议。
Thank you all for joining our earnings call for the second quarter of 2021.
我们很高兴二季度保持了强劲的业绩表现，收入达到4.52亿人民币，超过公司指引高端的4.5亿人民币。 相比2020年同期增长了38%，归属于新氧国际的非美国通用会计准则净利润为7370万元人民币，相比2020年同期增长145%，移动端平均月活达1000万，同比增长48%，预约服务的付费用户数为24.5万。 相比2020年同期增长41%，平台的付费医疗机构数达4899家，相比2020年同期增长31%。二季度齿科业务预约服务的付费用户数约1.48万，相比去年同期增长约120%，促成齿科交易的就诊专科机构数量达2915家。
We are very pleased to report another strong quarter. Revenue growth to RMB 452 million, exceeding the high end of our guidance of RMB 415 million, an increase of 38% from the same period of 2020. Now, GAAP net income attributable to So-Young International Inc. reached RMB 74 million, an increase of 145% from the second quarter of 2020. Average mobile MAUs were 10 million, up 48% year over year. Total number of users purchasing reservation services were 245,000, up 44% compared with the same period of 2020. The number of paying medical service providers our platform was 4,899, up 31% from the second quarter of last year. During the quarter, the number of users from purchasing reservation services in dental treatments grew approximately 120% year over year to about 14,800, and the number of professional dental institutions on our platform grew to 2,915, increasing by more than three times from the same period last year.
二季度，我们收购了国内一家在新三板挂牌的医疗激光企业——武汉奇智，进一步拓展了在非手术领域的竞争优势，并在同上游设备、器械和药剂合作上谋求新思路。 奇智主要从事激光和其他光电类医疗及美容设备研发、生产、销售和代理。 拥有自研和代理共十多条产品线，是国内光电厂商中覆盖项目最全的企业，能解决不同的用户的多类皮肤类需求。根据旗帜公开披露的2021年上半年财报显示，其2021年上半年营业收入同比增长119%，归属于其股东的净利润同比增长252%。稳健的业绩以及新的业务发展战略，使得我们不断努力精细化运营，满足终端用户和合作伙伴快速变化的需求，扩大市场份额。
In the second quarter, we announced the acquisition of a controlling interest in Wuhan Miracle Laser Systems, the first medical laser company listed on the National Equities Exchange and Quotations, or NEQ Exchange in China. The acquisition will further enhance our competitive advantages in the non-surgical aesthetic segment and allow us to explore new cooperation opportunities with upstream equipment, device, and medical drug providers. Wuhan Miracle is mainly engaged in R&D production, sales, and agent service for lasers and other photoelectric medical and aesthetics equipment. It has more than 10 product lines, including both self-owned and licensed-owned. Wuhan Miracle covers the broadest range of projects among photoelectric manufacturers and is able to solve diversified skin needs of different users. According to its reported results, the revenue for the first half of 2021 increased by 119% year-over-year, and net profit attributable to Wuhan Miracle for the first half of 2021 increased by 252% year-over-year. Our solid results and new strategy have enabled us to consistently improve our operations to meet the increasing changing demand from our end users and business partners, and expand our market share.
科技行业医美行业的科技创新，促进了消费者对医美治疗和服务的认知，受益于其保持健康外表和抗衰老的功效，非手术类项目热度不断攀升，市场增长强劲。二季度，平台非手术类收入占总收入的比例由去年同期的40%上升到46%，用户预订的非手术的订单量同比去年增长40%，非手术类订单占整体订单比例达70%。
Innovative technologies in medical aesthetics are driving an increasing awareness of aesthetic treatments and service among consumers. Notably, the popularity of non-surgical procedures to maintain healthy appearance or promote anti-aging benefits is constantly growing. In the second quarter, the revenue contribution of our non-surgical business increased to 46% of our total revenue, up from 40% in the second quarter last year. The reservation orders from non-surgical procedures increased by 40% year-over-year, and the reservation orders from non-surgical procedures accounted for 70% of total orders.
在运营策略上，首先结合社区内容以及我们的新媒体资源优势，打造推出新品和爆款产品。二季度，平台向用户介绍推荐优质口碑的核心产品，如 Photona4D、光子嫩肤、HYTE 等核心品类。用户在线下单量同比增长了超过100%，其中 Photona4D 的用户在线下单量甚至同比增长超过500%。
Moving over to our operational strategy. Firstly, leveraging our community content and advantages in new media resources, we'll continue to develop and launch fresh and highly successful products. In the second quarter, we have been stepping up efforts to recommend core products with good word of mouth to users on our platform, including Photona4D, Photo Rejuvenation, HYTE, and Xtrental, which result in a year-over-year increase of over 100% for online orders. Online orders for Photona4D even increased by 500% year-over-year.
在非手产品端，我们不断优化平台线上交易体验，扩充平台单品数量，提供更加透明以及更有吸引力的价格。先后推出先行赔付、医美保险等线上化的消费保障。二季度末，平台非手SKU数量超过14万，相比去年同期增长41%。
On the non-surgical product side, we continue to optimize the online transaction experience, increasing the number of SKUs on our platform and provided more transparent and attractive prices. We also launched an online consumer protection project, such as in advanced compensation and medical beauty insurance. At the end of June, over 140,000 non-surgical SKUs were available on our platform, an increase of 41% compared with the same period last year.
其次，继续强化非手的标准化，强化在产品设备等方面的掌控力度，保障用户履约体验。对旗帜的战略投资，不仅可以扩大我们在机构端的服务网络，更可以深入到用户履约环节，保障用户享受正品的消费体验。 使得我们在非手领域的竞争更加多元化，形成长远的竞争优势。
Secondly, we continue to strengthen the standardization of non-surgical procedures and enhance our management and control of products and equipment to optimize user experience. The strategic investment in Wuhan Miracle will not only expand our service network for institutional clients, but clinics. Institutional clients, but also improve our fulfillment service and ensure that we are able to offer authentic products to customers. With acquisition, our service in the non-surgical categories will become more diversified, creating a competitive moat in the long term.
最后，我们会继续拓展与更多医疗设备厂商的合作，帮助用户严格筛选药品、医疗器械。 和提供服务的机构，保证用户正品、真品选择。Lastly,
to ensure our users are guaranteed only authentic products and don't have to worry about safety issues on aesthetics treatment and services, we will continue to deepen our cooperation with our network of medical device manufacturers in order to consistently screen drugs, medical device, and service providers.
在热门品类拓展上，齿科也在持续发力，依托与企业客户的合作，连接用户和医疗机构，通过导入标准化体系，提升医疗机构服务品质，最终为用户提供优质的齿科医疗服务体验。We
continue to develop more popular categories such as dental services. By working with institutional clients, we connected users with institutions and offered them premier dental services by bringing a standardized system to enhance the service quality of these institutions.
关于行业监管，过去几个月，中国监管部门在包括反垄断、数据安全和医美广告宣传等方面发表了看法，出台了涉及多个行业的一系列政策和指导意见。作为行业的领头羊，我们也利用这个机会反观自身。 深入内省和反思。首先，新氧自创立之初，就已经组建了严苛的医生机构审核准入制度和流程，以及内容和商品的审核机制。其次，在提供互联网医美信息服务的过程中，积极听取各级市场监管部门的指导，建立健全并优化了内部审核机制。 同时，新氧也一直在积极开展中国医美行业自律，推动平台治理，协助平台上的机构做好合规的审核，维护医美行业规范有序的发展环境。On
the regulatory front, over the past few months, regulatory authorities have expressed their views and opinions on various matters such as antitrust, data security, and medical aesthetics advertising, and issued a series of policies and guidance for multiple industries. We have taken this opportunity to reflect on our practice and our role as an industry leader and engage in self-reflection and introspection. First of all, since our inception, we have established a stringent review and approval process for all doctors and institutions, as well as conducted rigorous review mechanism for content and service offering our platform. In addition, following the guidance issued by regulatory bodies at various levels, we have an established internal review process and continue to improve the online information we provided of medical aesthetic services. At the same time, we have also been actively engaged in the self-discipline of China's medical aesthetics industry by promoting platform governance and assisting our institution partners with compliance audits, and promoting a standardized and orderly development of the medical aesthetics industry.
综上所述，我们认为中国医美行业正处在稳步增长的道路上。作为行业的领导者，我们有责任通过促进行业规范的建立，使医美行业越来越好，为用户提供真正有价值的服务。展望未来，我们将充分利用我们在内容、科技和用户方面的竞争优势，以用户为中心，深入行业产业链，以医美为切入点，构建成为最受信赖的医美医疗服务平台。
To summarize, we believe the Chinese medical aesthetics industry is well on the track of steady growth. As a leader in the industry, we have the responsibility to make industry better by promoting industry standards and providing authentic and truly valuable services for our users. Looking forward, we will leverage our competitive advantages in content, technology, and our large user base.And continue to focus our efforts on user acquisition and expand our online presence into other segments of the industry. By making use of medical aesthetics as an entry point, Soyoung will be built as the most trusted medical aesthetics and medical care platform in China.
下面请我们的 CFO 于敏介绍本季度的财务情况，之后我们将开始 Q&A 环节。
Let me invite Ming to give us an overview of our result for the quarter and before the operator will open the QA.
Thanks, Cass. Please be reminded that all amounts quoted here will be in RMB. Please also refer to our earnings release for detailed information of our comparative financial performance on a year-over-year basis.For the second quarter 2021, total revenues were RMB 451.8 million, up 37.7% year over year from RMB 328.2 million, and exceeded the high end of our prior guidance of RMB 450 million. The increase was primarily due to an increase in average revenue per paying medical service provider. The number of paying medical service providers on the platform was 4,899, an increase of 31.2% from 3,735 in the second quarter of 2020. The total number of medical service providers subscribing to information services on Soyoung's platform was 2,236 during the quarter, an increase of 8.8% from 2,056 in the second quarter of 2020. Within total revenues, information services revenue were RMB 360 million, up 53.8% year over year from RMB 234.5 million. Reservation services revenues were RMB 91.9 million, a decrease of 2.8% from RMB 93.7 million in the second quarter of 2020. Cost of revenues RMB 58.8 million, up 15.9% year over year from RMB 50.7 million in the second quarter of 2020. Cost of revenues included share-based compensation expenses of RMB 3.8 million compared with RMB 6 million in the second quarter of 2020. Total operating expenses were RMB 335.4 million, up 16.7% from RMB 287.4 million in the second quarter of 2020. Sales and marketing expenses were RMB 206.7 million, up 11.6% from RMB 185.2 million a year ago, primarily due to an increase in payroll costs associated with the expansion of marketing employees. Sales and marketing expenses included share-based compensation expenses of RMB 1.6 million compared with RMB 1.6 million in the corresponding period of 2020. General and administrative expenses were RMB 56.5 million, up 13.3% from RMB 49.8 million a year ago, primarily due to an increase in payroll costs associated with the expansion of administrative employees. General and administrative expenses included share-based compensation expenses of RMB 7.2 million compared with RMB 14.2 million in the corresponding period of 2020. Research and development expenses were RMB 72.1 million, up 37.9% from RMB 52.3 million a year ago. The increase was primarily attributable to an increase in payroll costs associated with the expansion of research and development employees. Research and development expenses from the second quarter of 2021 included share-based compensation expenses of RMB 3.6 million compared with RMB 6.2 million in the corresponding period of 2020. Income tax expenses were RMB 11.1 million compared with RMB 2.8 million in the second quarter of 2020. Net income attributable to So-Young International Inc. was RMB 57.6 million compared with net income attributable to So-Young International Inc. of RMB 2.1 million in the second quarter of 2020. Non-GAAP net income attributable to So-Young International Inc. was RMB 73.7 million compared with RMB 30.1 million in non-GAAP net income attributable to So-Young International Inc. in the same period of 2020. Basic and diluted income per ADS attributable to ordinary shareholders were RMB 0.54 and RMB 0.53 respectively, compared with RMB 0.02 and 0.02 respectively during the same quarter during the second quarter of 2020. Now for our balance sheet. As of June 30, 2021, we had a total cash and cash equivalents, restricted cash and term deposits and short-term investments of RMB 2.26 billion compared with RMB 2.68 billion as of December 31, 2020. For the third quarter of 2021, So-Young expects total revenues to be between RMB 430 million to RMB 450 million, representing a 66.6% to 69.7% increase from the same period in 2020. The above outlook is based on the current market conditions and reflects the company's preliminary estimates of the market and operating conditions and customer demand. This concludes our prepared remarks. I will now turn the call to the operator and open the call for Q&A. Operator, we are ready to take questions.
Thank you. We will now begin the question and answer session. If you wish to ask a question, please press star 1 on your telephone keypad and wait for your name to be announced. If you wish to cancel your request, please press the pound or hash key. If you ask question in Chinese, please repeat it in English immediately, and one person is allowed to ask one question at a time. If you want to ask more than one question, please join the queue again. Your first question comes from Thomas Chong of Jefferies. Please ask your question.
谢谢管理层接受我的提问。我有一个问题，就是针对最近国家市场那个检察管理总局发布的一个针对医疗美容广告的一个指南上面，公司是如何看待？
还有就是这个对我们公司的业务有做成影响吗？Now I will translate myself. What are the company's views regarding the recent changes on the advertising guidelines regulating the beauty medical sector, which were issued by the State Administration for Market Regulation, and how it will affect the company business moving forward? Thank you.
哎，你好。我们注意到了年初至今政府监管部门发布的文件，主要集中在对医疗机构开展医疗美容活动做了规定。我们认为行业的严格监管有利于行业整体的长远健康发展。
Thank you. We noticed that documents issued by regulatory authorities since the beginning of this year have mainly been focused on supervising the practice of medical institutions in the medical aesthetic sector. We believe that such supervision is conducive to the long-term and healthy development of the entire industry.
新氧作为一家互联网医美信息服务平台，自创立之初就已经组建了严苛的机构、医生审核、准入制度和流程，以及内容和商品的审核机制。我们一直致力于打造平台治理，力争从源头上尽力遏制不合规的行为。
As an internet medical aesthetics information service platform, since our inception, we have established a strict review and approval process for all the doctors and institutions we partner with, as well as content and product review mechanisms.We are committed to build strong governance across our platform and strive to curb any non-compliant activities.
从信息展示角度来看，机构如果要与新氧合作，需要提交有国家颁发的营业执照、医疗机构执业许可证等资料。经过我们内部的合规审核及实名认证后，才能与新氧建立合作。展示的医生信息需要医生提供医师资格证和医师执业证，才可能在新氧的平台展示。
In terms of having medical information featured on our platform, in order to cooperate with Soyang, medical institutions are required to submit their state-issued business license, medical institution practice license, and other documents issued by governance authoritiesAs well as pass our internal review and verification, we also require doctors to provide their qualification certificates and verify practice license before information can be published on our platform.
从商品及内容展示的角度看，我们利用风控反作弊系统建立了一套严苛的信息展示系统。机构所展示的信息首先要符合我们系统的要求。此外，我们还会有两道机器审核及人工审核。
In terms of publishing content on products and services, we have built a rigorous information display system equipped with risk control and anti-fraud systems. Information displayed by institutions must first meet our strict requirements, and we have two additional review procedures.One automated and the other by manual inspections.
新氧还配备专业的合规团队，实时跟进国家政策及标准，优化平台自身审核系统及标准，同时拥有一套严苛的违规信息风控模型库，专业的内部风控管理和平台治理，也是我们区别于其他竞对平台的优势。
We have also a professional compliance team that closely monitors state policies and standards in real time, which we then compile to optimize our platform's verification system and standardization process. We also have a strict set of violation information risk control model library. Because of professional internal risk control management and platform governance,we think that this should be the operational strength that differentiates from our peers.
去年五月，我们在业内率先发起了中国医美行业自律行动，推动平台治理动作的同时，针对市场监管总局制定的征求意见稿，将充分站在保护消费者的合法权益的前提下，通过相应的途径和方式反馈意见，为医美行业从业者发声的同时，更好地服务消费者，维护医美行业规范有序的发展环境。
Last May, we initiated a self-discipline campaign for China's medical aesthetics industry to promote platform governance. Regarding the draft guidelines on regulating advertising in the medical aesthetics sector issued by the SAMR, we will provide our feedback through appropriate channels on the premise of protecting the legal rights and interests of consumers.Through positive and constructive feedback, we aim to create a voice for medical aesthetics professionals and at the same time provide better service to our customers and promote a regulated and orderly environment for the development of the industry.
同时，我们也认为监管的严格和细则推动执行，要求线下医疗机构加强自身服务能力和医疗水平。并在投放获客时不能一味追求流量，甚至用虚假夸大的方式欺骗消费者。对于机构而言，在投放渠道上的选择会更加审慎，同时执法指南也明确了对网络平台经营者的履约和审核责任，会加强网络平台合法合规的治理。从这一点上来看，新氧作为行业中最早和持续进行行业自律行为的平台，长期看是受益的。
Meanwhile, we also believe that with strict regulation and further execution of specific rules, offline medical institutions are required to enhance their services capability and medical level, not blindly pursue traffic growth in marketing and user acquisition, and even cheated consumers with fake or special aids.Institutions will be more cautious selecting marketing channels. Also, the enforcement guidance also clarifies that online platform operators' duties to perform contract and do the verification, and governance online platform compliance will be enhanced. In this regard, as the first mover in the industry to start and continuously establish self-discipline,We believe that Soyoung will be benefited by the regulation in the long run.
长远来看，政府有关部门的监管有利于整个行业的健康发展。新氧将从自身做起，坚持行业自律，进一步完善内部审核机制，在信息发布、提供互联网信息服务的过程中，拦截违法违规医疗美容宣传信息，促进医美行业回归医疗本质。
In the long term, we believe that the regulations will prove to be highly conducive to the healthy development of the industry. For Soyoung, we are committed to adhere to all regulations and will continue to further improve our internal review mechanism to full compliance and regular self-governance. To lead by example, we will remain proactive in intercepting medical aesthetics promotional information that doesn't comply to the rules. In order to offer authentic information and online services and promote better care in the medical aesthetics industry.
就是这些。
Okay, thank you. That's all.
Your next question comes from Nelson Chang of Citi. Please ask your question.
谢谢管理层接受我的提问，然后恭喜你们二季度非常强的业绩。然后我的问题是关于公司未来业务的发展的，我就是想理解一下疫情其实对公司的业务的影响到底有多大，然后我们是如何看待下半年的业务增长的趋势呢？然后我还有另外一个最后的问题就是关于美资卡的，就是想问一下美资卡在这个季度或者是未来有没有一些进展呢？So let me translate myself into English. thanks management for taking my question. So my question is regarding to the business prospects. Can management share your views related to the impact of COVID on your business? And can you share more details about the growth trend in going into the second half of this year? And my second question is related to the your progress on the Soyang Pass, the SY Pass. Yeah, thank you.
你好，受七八月份疫情水灾等影响，我们看到上海、成都、南京、郑州等一二线城市机构运营均受到影响。随着影响的减弱，我们也看到这些城市机构的运营正在逐步恢复到正常的增长水平。
In July and August, China faced the double impact of COVID-19.Resurfacing in a few cities and damages from flooding disasters. Operations of medical institutions were adversely affected in the first tier and second tier cities such as Shanghai, Chengdu, Nanjing, and Zhengzhou. And as the situation got under control, medical institutions were able to resume operations and return to their regular growth trend.
监管政策，特别是针对医疗美容广告法，令在短期内要求各机构先进行自查，对于不合规范的医美产品和项目需要进行下架处理。同时执法指南也明确要求网络平台经营者需依法履行平台责任，短期内机构会更加审慎地进行投放。
Looking to the business growth in the second half of this year, firstly, policies in particular regulations for medical aesthetics advertising required institutions to conduct self-inspection first in the near term and pull unqualified products and treatments from their offerings. Meanwhile, the enforcement guidelines also set clear requirements for online platform operators.To fulfill the duties imposed by laws. As a result, institutions will be more cautious about marketing in the near term.
下半年受益于非手项目热度不断攀升，在保有手术类项目优势的基础上，我们在非手上也会继续执行既定的战略，不断渗透和拓展市场份额。
In the second half of this year, taking advantage of the rising popularity of non-surgical treatments, we will continue to implement our established strategy to grow the non-surgical categories, further penetrate and expand market share while maintaining our strength in the surgical category.
关于美次卡，截至八月底，美次卡业务覆盖城市由 Q1 的11个拓展到36个城市。覆盖机构数95个，拓展到超过160个，验证订单数 Q2 环比 Q1 增长了40%。
As of the end of August, Soyang Pass has extended its network to 36 cities from 11 Q1, and the number of institutions increased from 95 to over 160.The number of verified orders on Soyang Pass also increased by 40% in Q2 compared to Q1.
就是这些，谢谢。
That's all, thank you.
Your next question comes from Leo Chang of Deutsche Bank. Please ask your question.
Hey, 管理层晚上好，谢谢接受我的提问。那我的提问是关于那个行业竞争的方面，可以请管理层跟我们更新一下那个最新的行业的这个竞争格局吗？Let me myself. So thanks management for taking my question. My question is regarding to competition landscape. Can management share the latest competition landscape you have observed recently? Thank you.
你好，现阶段的市场我们认为已经不是纯流量的竞争了，而是需要平台是否能够真正解决用户在真实消费体验中的痛点。不管是从监管的角度还是从用户体验上，都需要有专业的平台对行业有深入的了解。
At current level of market competition, we believe it is no longer purely about competing for user traffic, but whether platform can really address a pain point for users and improve user experience. From the perspective of both regulation and better user experience, platform must be professional at all times and have in-depth knowledge of the industry.
随着飞手项目热度不断提高，我们也继续加强在飞手上的运营，执行我们的既定战略，在不断扩大整体的医美消费人群基础上，扩展市场份额。
As the popularity of non-surgical category increases in demand, we will continue to strengthen the operation of non-surgical category and implement our established strategy to expand market share.On top of growing our entire medical aesthetics user base.
同时我们也在不断加强与其他平台的合作，赋能整个医美行业。我们联手京东健康，共建京东健康医美频道，使消费者在京东健康医美频道可以获得专业优质医美服务体验。此外，我们还与高德联合打通了超过1000家医美机构，共建高德平台的医美用户消费链路。我们的新氧美次卡还与小红书、拼多多、快手、微博形成战略合作，深挖轻医美消费热点，搭建高品质的选品池，扩大范围赋能医美机构。
Meanwhile, we are continuously strengthening our cooperation with other platforms to empower the entire medical aesthetics industry. For instance, we partner with JD.com to establish a JD Healthy Medical Aesthetics channel so that consumers can experience and have easy access to professional and premier medical aesthetic services. Besides that, we also worked with AutoNavy to connect with other 1,000 institutions and established a consumer service for medical aesthetics users on the AMAP platform. Soyang Pass has also achieved more strategic cooperations with like Little Red Book, Pinduoduo, Kuaishou, and Weibo, and we hope to explore popular treatments in medical aesthetics.Build a premier shortlist of select products and expand our service scope to continue empowering more institutions.
就是这些，谢谢。
That's all, thank you.
Your next question comes from the line of Vincent Yu from Needham and Company. Please ask your question.
好的，好的，谢谢管理层啊。然后这个估计这个也是比较强的一个季度。那我这边有两个问题啊。第一个是我听到这个前面的分析师已经问过关于这个监管对于我们公司广告方面的影响，然后也想就继续再跟进一下。我们认为这个监管的变化对于这个现在医美行业，就是不论是这个广告也好，或者说可能对于过去的一些比较传统的。这个行业的这个结构也好，产生了哪些变化吗？然后第二个问题是关于我们最近的一个这个收购，也想问一下管理层，关于这个收购背后我们的这个策略是怎么样子呢？就是说，和我们的未来的这些医院或者说这个机构啊，是怎么未来是期望怎么一个合作模式啊？然后呢，未来在这个策略背后，我们是希望达到怎么样的一个货币化的期望？那我很快翻一下啊。Thanks management, thank you for taking my question. I have two questions. One is to follow up on the impact on the regulation. So my question is not like it's more focused on how the regulation.Impacts the traditional the industry structure and the traditional practices in this industry and how we should view this as a potential opportunity. And second question is on the Rian's acquisition. How should we think about the strategy behind this acquisition? What kind of cooperation we will have? Between this manufacturing company and the our institution clients, and also what kind of monetization model we are hoping to see for the future. Yes, thank you.
你好，监管的严格规定在一定程度上打击了行业原有的一些不规范的现状，长远来看呢，我们认为是有利于整个行业的健康发展。随着监管的加强，各地对于机构医生的审核准入制度和流程会更加的明细清晰，同时加强对于药品器械的使用规范，对于市场中生产流通使用正品真品厂商和机构也是更有效的保护。
First, we believe that the regulation action against the non-compliant practice and strict regulatory requirements will benefit the healthy development of the whole industry in the long run. With tightening of regulations, local regulation will further clarify and detail the approval system and process for institutions and doctors. Meanwhile, the usage specifications for drugs and equipment will be strengthened, forming more effective protection for manufacturers and institutions producing, distributing, and using genuine and authentic products.
除了在准入合规上，我们看到行业随着监管力度加大，一定程度上促进了机构提升从营销获客到内部运营水平，提高服务质量。除了教育消费者辨别和选择，机构需要通过好服务、好技术留下顾客。如果只注重获客，不重视管理和服务顾客，这样的医美机构是不能长久存在的。
Beyond entry compliance, we are seeing that the stricter regulation will to some extent drive institutions to raise the level from their marketing, customer acquisition to internal operation, so as to improve service quality. Besides educating consumers to distinguish and select services, institutions need to retain clients with good service and skills.An institution won't survive for long by focusing only on customer acquisition and ignoring management and service quality.
市场监管的加强对于医美市场的整体，特别是轻医美市场的标准化、线上化的进步，我们认为是会有非常明显的促进作用的。
Tightened market regulation has significant driving effect.On standardization and going online for the entire medical aesthetics market, particularly the non-surgical medical aesthetics market.
关于旗帜的问题，请 CFO 于敏来回答。
Yes, I will try to answer your questions about our acquisition of Miracle Laser. As mentioned earlier in the case remarks, in the previous part, Miracle Laser is the is one of the biggest manufacturer for laser medical machineries in China, and we think the synergies going forward between the platform at Soyang and the further cooperation with the manufacturers with branded manufacturers like Wuhan Miracle. We'll have a new complete service experience for users on the platform, and at the same time, we can make sure the services taken by the customers will have a very consistent experience. It also will have certain cost-saving effect, we will provide our platform customers directly.To the clinic or hospitals who have Wuhan Miracle's medicine instruments or equipment directly, and we will share the revenues between that. And it will be a showcase attempt for us for the further cooperations with upstream manufacturers in medical aesthetic service industry. Going forward, we will see further cooperations with other branded manufacturers to provide consistent and, of course, the consistent screening drugs and medical devices and service providers to our customers. At the same time, Wuhan Miracle itself is a very well-run business. They have been listed in the NEED exchange in China for almost 6 years, being highly compliant in terms of financial control and internal control. And they have been experiencing, of course, in the industry as a whole has been hit by the COVID-19 in 2020, but they have been recovered quite well in the first half of this year. And we are very positive for its going forward growth after be acquired by us, and our cooperation will adding more elements for the business in the going forward. Okay, that's it. Thanks.
Thank you.
Our next question comes from the line of Chi Chi Ye from CICC. Please ask your question.
哎，好，哎，感谢管理层接受我的提问。首先是非常恭喜，强劲的业绩。我们看到二季度这个 sales marketing 的花费的绝对值比一季度是要少的，然后 MAU 的增长趋势也不错。想请教一下公司下半年的投放趋势。Thanks management for taking my question and congrats on your strong performance. We noticed that the absolute value of sales marketing expenses have declined sequentially. Can you please comment on any marketing and promotion trends in the second half of this year? Thank you.
哎，你好。下半年呢，其实我们会更加有针对性的来做品牌投放，持续占领用户心智，然后同时发挥平台优势。 以优质的内容在其他第三方平台做效果投放，树立专业医美平台的形象。We
are planning to execute more targeted brand placement to strengthen brand awareness among our users. At the same time, we will leverage the advantage of our platform and conduct performance-based marketing on third-party platforms with premium content to establish our brand as professional medical aesthetics platform.
从全年来看呢，我们整体的销售和市场费用占收入的比例，预计不会超过50%的水平。For
the full year, we forecast that the sales marketing expense as a percentage of our revenues will remain largely stable at no more than 50%.
就是这样。Well,
that's all. Thank you.
Thank you.
As there are no further questions, this concludes today's conference call. Thank you for participating. You may now all disconnect.